The CS reiterated the government's commitment to conducting free and fair elections and added that the proposed amendment of the election laws had no ulterior motive and was only meant to act as a backup in the event the BVR kids failed, adding that no system is entirely foolproof.
If the transmission fails, mm-hmm. how do you, are you going to conduct it? Mm-hmm. You would definitely have, even in America itself, yes. we had both. They are both in operation, isn't it? So which other way? Are they giving us a way forward? Scientifically, what cannot fail?
Meanwhile, elders drawn from the Samburu and Dorobo communities have called a truce after years of conflict over limited resources and agreed to respect territorial boundaries. Isiolo Deputy Commissioner Chaunga Mwachaunga said security measures have been put in place to tame cattle rustling that has been the major cause of conflict.
Iwapo jamii ya fulani itaenda kuiba mifugo pahali popote, mifugo ile itafuatwa nyayo, na pale mifugo imingia, itakuwa ni jukumu la watu wa pale kuitoa mifugo ile. Aidha mifugo ile iliyoingia pale ipatikane, na kama haitawezekana basi jamii nzima itachukua ilo jukumu la kuhakikisha kama mifugo ile inapatikana irudishwe wenyewe wameibiwa.
Elsewhere, 3 people have died and 20 houses razed down in an inter-clan conflict between the Kapseren and Kapsoi clans in Tot Elgeyo Marakwet County. Tension remains high in the area. Police Commander Hezron Opio has warned stern action will be taken against those found fanning the conflict. And the Ministry of Lands, Housing and Urban Development has handed over 250 housing units to the Department of Criminal Investigations. Speaking during the handover, PS for Housing Aida Munano said the project targets to deliver 100,000 units in the next 5 years. The project is part of the government's 4-year infrastructure development project aimed at alleviating the acute housing crisis facing the National Police Service.
We have confirmed that these houses are livable in, they are habitable. We are here with the users who are the who are CID officers. In fact, we are with the commandant here.
And finally, police in Muranga have raided hideouts along Chania River where illicit brew was being manufactured. Over 10,000 litres of illicit brews was destroyed during the crackdown. County Commissioner John Elingata said the brew was being stored in an unhygienic environment, posing serious health risks to the consumers. The officers were forced to blow up stones used to conceal and brew the drink. Police have since launched a manhunt for the suspects who escaped when they spotted their police officers. Mary Moki for Channel 1 News Hour.